Hi friends, welcome to Tricky Globe. Today we are going on to learn about the shortcut method to find the square root. Suppose I have to find the square root of 841. To find this, we need a table that is easier table that everyone know it, that is 1 square 1, 2 square is 4. 3 then 10 square is 100. Now we have to make a pair from the right hand side. So this is a pair and this is another pair. So for first pair we have 8. Now we have to check out 8 is in between 4 and 9. So we have to take the smaller number, that is 2. Okay, now to find the another number we have to check it out, what is the first digit. First digit is 1, right? Now 1 come up in the unit digit in here and here, that is this will come up either 1 or 9, right? So which will come up, either 1 or 9? Now we have to find which one will come up here, either 1 or 9. To find this you have to multiply 2 with the next number, that is 2 into 3, that is 6. Now we can see 8 is bigger than 6, okay? Because 8 is bigger than 6, so we'll take the bigger number, that is 9. So answer is 29. We can take another example. You can take any example actually. Square root of 1024. Now again we have to make a pair, that is 24, and for 10, 10 is in between 9 and 16. So our first digit would be 3. Now for the second digit we have 4. 4 is there in 2, this one, or in 8, this one. This means here it will come up either 2 or 8. To find which one will come up, you have to multiply 3 just with the next number, that is 3 into 4, that is 12. Now you can see 10 is smaller than 12, so you have to take the smaller number. 10 is smaller than 12. So we have to take the smaller number among both of these, 2 and 8. The smaller number is 2. So answer to be 32. You can check it out with any numbers. Now there is a confusion. What will come up when this number is equal to this number? So in case of equal to, like suppose I'm gonna take another example, that is root of 1296. In case of 1296, we are going to make a pair 96 and 12. 12 is in between 9 and 16. So we are going to take the smaller number, that is 3. So we can write it down 3. Now for 6, we have two options, either 4 or 6. So we have two options, 4 or 6. To find this, what do you have to do? 3 multiplied by the next number, that is 3 into 4. That is 12. Now this 12 and this is equal. In case of equal, we are going to take the bigger number, not the smaller number. Keep it in your mind. Okay? In case of equal or bigger number, we are going to take only the bigger number. In this way, you can find the square root of any number which is a complete square. Thanks for watching my video. Keep on watching my video and try to share, comment and like it.